During this meeting, the President first commended Germany for its donation of 5.5 million doses of the Johnson & Johnson COVID-19 vaccine. He explained that Uganda has already started on the journey to develop its own COVID-19 vaccine, but is still hindered by the inadequate reagents to produce the vaccine. He made a passionate appeal to Germany to help share its reagents with Uganda.
We know a lot of these plants. They have a lot of potential. Even this corona, one of the reasons corona did not kill so many of us was that we were using the herbs. They cure. The professors have proved that some of the plants have antiviral, some of them have antibacterial. So it's very good. We are ready. We are ready with that idea. It would be good if we could make the factory here to extract the active ingredients. Because like when you talk of malaria, I was on malaria plants when I was young. That's what my mother was giving me. And I know those plants. I know them myself.
The President, who is also pushing for stronger partnerships with German investors in various sectors of agriculture, health and pharmaceuticals, energy and infrastructure development, singled out various sectors, including pharmaceuticals, using local plants where the Germans can invest.
The post-harvest management is a very big interest for us because we lose a lot of food because of bad post-harvest management. So therefore, any equipment or technology that deals with that problem is most welcome. And if there is a company which can invest in that equipment, either here or even import, we shall be very, very happy.
The German investors delegation was led by the German ambassador to Uganda, Matthias Schauer. Schauer informed the president that the delegation had toured the Bukasa inland port near Kampala, that the members of the delegation were keen to partner in developing the mining, infrastructure and agriculture sectors.
For the first time in 2 years, we have a business delegation here, and it's a strong delegation, and we have it here thanks to the Ugandan embassy in Berlin, to Ambassador Sorsi, to Minister Councillor Margaret Otiskov. They really went out on a limb to do this in a very short time, and we are really happy with the cooperation.
The President also met a delegation from India, which was led by the Minister of State for External Affairs and Parliamentary Affairs in the Government of India, Shri Mrajdalin. Mrajdalin thanked President Museveni for his support of the Indian community in Uganda and for supporting India at the United Nations Security Council, and assured him that his government will arrange for a subsidy in solar energy generation through the New Delhi-based International Solar Alliance.
Prime Minister has been very vocally explaining the situation. He has given a slogan of one world, one sun, one grid for the entire world. So the whole countries, every country can be united on the basis of the solar energy.
Yes.
So to promote that, the International Solar Alliance, which offers a lot of benefits, lot of facilities, that could be utilized by Uganda.
President Museveni said he would work with the Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi, regarding India's offer of a concessional credit facility to promote rural power transmission and value addition in agriculture. Story by Jaliat Namoya for the news in Entebbe.